was like, yeah, honestly, I can't even tell you.
Yeah, crazy. As long as we can get this, then we're good. But how are you keeping, bud?
Yeah, man. All right. Yeah, obviously, just trying to stay busy during this crazy time. Yeah. So our company is back at work. We started about 2 weeks ago, which is quite cool.
Yeah.
So yeah, man, just trying to stay fit as well in the gym. Just been doing some little odd jobs around the house. Been skating a bit. Been shooting some dussies. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, just trying to keep busy.
I hear you. So what does your company actually do? I know you're working with your dad or for your dad or whatnot. But what is it actually?
So it's his company. So we basically supply all the petrol garages in South Africa with emergency spares.
Okay.
So we've got a stand inside there called Hazard. It's a Hazard emergency spares. And basically we just repackage and sell it onto the garages.
Okay, fantastic. Well, that's good. Yeah. Keeping yourself busy during the tough time when a lot of guys are sitting at home like myself and not doing much other than housework.
No, definitely. It is. It's crazy how you realize now when, like, obviously not a lot of people have work, how, like, you appreciate the actual work when you do have it.
For sure. 100%. Yeah, it's an interesting time, but we'll get through it as a nation, I guess.
Definitely.
We were already on it this morning. I mean, your injuries over the last few years, you've lost your contract now recently because of back-to-back years of maybe sort of pestering injuries. I know all about them, but I mean, for the other guys that are going to watch this, let's inform them on what's actually happened with you.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, it's actually quite funny. I think our Instagram live attempt this morning was much like my cricket career. A lot of starts. And then a lot of stops. So it's quite ironic. But I think, sure, pretty much my whole cricket career has been involved with injuries. So it's been tough, but I also think it's built a lot of character in me. I think I'm able to deal with setbacks quite well, just because of it's pretty much been in my whole career. So it's nothing new to me. But yeah, I think the past, say, 3-4 seasons have probably been the toughest. Obviously, the older you get, the more reality hits, and the more you have to be real with yourself. I picked up a few niggles, and they were always the same sort of injuries around the hamstring area, lower back area, those sort of things. And like, I was always told, like 2 week or that sort of stuff, you know, and possibly I was. But then I had started doing the proper training, correct stretching, all of that sort of stuff, because that's really important. But it just kept happening. So like, and it happened at the weirdest of times. It wasn't like even in my bowling action, it was when I was like trotting or something. So it wasn't making too much sense. So we went for an MRI, and they found out a cam and a pincer in my hip, which basically is just extra bone in your hip. And that obviously was, my body was overcompensating to miss that and not let that pinch. So then it would pull tight in other areas. And obviously then that's why my hamstring was tight and my lower back was tight, because your whole body starts going out of proportion or out of place.
So
it was a tough decision to go through with the op, just because I knew the recovery time on it. I knew it was going to be a long road of recovery. But obviously during the time we sat down with the coaches and we said, this is going to be a decision for the future. And, you know, we're thinking future wise. I went through with the op. Yeah, I went through with the op and it was a successful op. The recovery was hectic. I think being an athlete and being active pretty much all day, to go sit in bed the whole day is quite tough. And it was a difficult time as well, because I was just married and my wife had just got a new job at Investec. Sure. So she was gone literally from, say, 5 o'clock in the morning till 8 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
So it was just that much harder, because I was sat here in the bed, I couldn't do anything. I couldn't really walk around. So it was a little bit tough, but it was a successful op. The recovery was good. Like, we had a good gym program in place, sort of strengthening work and that. And And yeah, then I got up on my feet for the 2018-2019 season, which was good. So my first tournament back was the Africa Cup, yes, which we didn't do too great in, but I felt pretty good. And then, yeah, obviously during last season, with having the opt done, now your body's obviously changed. So you pick up little niggles and that, which was a little bit frustrating, but I was trying to stay positive with it because I think I felt the strongest I'd ever felt. Also putting in the work in the gym and sort of stuff. And I think I was bowling my quickest that I had bowled. So to the end of the season, before obviously lockdown came in, I think I was feeling really good. But then obviously with the whole decision with the contract and that was a bit of a curveball, and yeah, so that's pretty much on my injury side.
Yeah, so that's sort of a tough time to go through something like this, because obviously we know we're in a tough situation around the world, but now you're obviously having that on the back burner as well as what's going on with the COVID thing, and I think it's not easy. So that brings me to my next question. What's sort of on the cards for you? I mean, again, I mentioned it, you and I know what's going on. We sort of got a game plan that we're working towards. But other guys that don't, they might think, you know, Carmi's left the building and not coming back. But let's update them with some of your goals and ambitions anyway.
Yeah, sure. So I think for anyone who's lost the contract, they know that it's not the nicest thing. So there's massive disappointments in the beginning, and I think anyone would be disappointed, and you sort of like reflect back and see what you could have maybe done different or some things like that. But I think it's just important, obviously, to, like you say, to have new goals, to have, I think it's really important to have good people around you, like family and just people to encourage you when you're feeling down, you know? Yeah. And obviously my faith plays a massive part in dictating my life. So I think that helped me as well after the news. Just get through that, and I think because I think it is tough. I think it's tough for anyone. So I think new goals, like you say, we've chatted in that. I think I'm just thinking of doing things a bit more unconventional. So trying to find different avenues to be playing cricket, because I'm not ready to throw in the towel just yet. I think I still have a lot to give. I think just more the unconventional way, sort of maybe not being stuck to one team. I think that's the way cricket is moving forward as well. Is there's a lot of different tournaments around the world, a lot of different formats. So I think it is moving sort of in that direction. Excuse me. So maybe just to find other avenues. I think sometimes we can box ourselves into doing one thing in a particular way. Yeah. And I think it's always good to try and get out of that and try find new ways. So yeah, like you say, we're working towards something, and yeah, it's exciting. I think it's the first time in my life where I haven't really been able to control my situation, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Previously I've always known, okay, I've got a contract. June is off-season training, and you know, you have your year pretty much planned out.
Yeah.
Where now I'm sitting, and it's scary, but it's exciting at the same time, because anything can happen. It's not just planned out. So just trying to keep that sort of mentality going. I think it's important for any youngsters that are going to watch this.
Yeah.
I think it's really important to have something to do after cricket, or even while you're doing cricket. I think with me losing the contract, I was obviously working in the company while I was playing cricket, more part-time. Obviously now I get a delve in a bit more deeper. I think it's so important to just have that sort of safety net, because I think if I didn't have anything and I lost the contract, I honestly don't know if I would have been able to cope, because now all of a sudden you have all this time on your hands. And I think a lot of, especially if you don't have your head screwed on right, I think a lot of guys can go down a dark road. So yeah, so that's pretty much where my mind is at. I'm still trying to stay fit and strong. Yeah.
That takes me to the next question. Now, I know you've got a gym at home. You're quite fortunate, whereas other guys are doing a bit of skipping and at best running your 5K in that time. But what are you doing? I know you're skating a bit, which is great. I mean, that adds a bit of diversity to fitness.
Yeah, I think with the skating, I think it's just, I think I've taken a bit of a step back as well, just trying to take my mind off of cricket a bit as well. I think it's important. I'm not doing too many hectic things because I know it's a little bit risky. But so like you say, we do have a little home gym here, which is great. Don't have to lug 5-liter water bottles to try and get the gains. It's got some good equipment that I can focus on the correct body parts and correct muscles. I think ending off last season, I was working quite close with Brett Edwards, and we got a good gym program going and a good stretching program and good foundational stuff. So just building on that. I'm trying to run quite a lot. It's so tough in winter because you know you get up early and it's still pitch black.
Yes.
And just trying to stay fit like that. It's quite tough, you know, lockdown and the eating, because it just spirals, and then the wife decides to bake, and then it just gets even worse. So
I hear you totally.
Yeah,
totally understand. Take me through that. You've been married now for like you said this morning, about a year and a half, or moving on towards a year and a half. How's that been? I know she's working as well, and I don't know if she's working now during lockdown, but is that all going well? You guys coping?
Yeah. It's been awesome. I think for a lot of couples, I think this lockdown, especially the initial lockdown, I think was quite a nightmare.
Yeah.
Because you're actually not really with your partner in reality quite a lot during the day if you guys are both working. But honestly, we have thoroughly enjoyed just spending time together, having quality time. Like you say, we live on a small plot, so it is quite nice in terms of space wise. We just get to go have walks, and which is quite nice.
Fantastic.
So she's working. She gets to go into the office twice a week. So she's actually moved from Investec. She works at the Donald Gordon Hospital for a cancer doctor.
Okay.
Yeah, so at least it's only twice a week, because we've also got a little pup. So she gets to be at home with him and sort of keep his attention.
Yes.
It's just been awesome, like getting to spend the time, you know. And I think it is important for any marriage, just that time to put in, you know.
Definitely. I think you're spot on. Yeah, the time could be tough, but it depends how you approach it, and then make the best of it. What are the hobbies you got? I know you're skating a bit. Personally, I know that you love motor vehicles and bikes. But I'm going to let you tell the guys more about that.
I've actually got quite a lot of passions and hobbies in that I try to keep myself busy with. Skating's always been a passion, and sort of put it on hold while cricket season was happening in that.
Yes.
But I thought it was a great opportunity, and like you say, it does. Listen, my legs are wrecked. Yeah. More so than a 3-day game. Not that I've played many of them, but it does work the legs a little bit. And then I'm quite into PCP air rifles. We've got quite a lot of dussies on the plot that are terrors to the garden. So we try to take them out a little bit, which is quite cool. And then obviously a massive motorhead, more so cars. But we do have a old school BMW R60 motorbike, which is cool. I know you want your hands on that.
I would love that.
So we can have a chat after the call. Cars. I've always been massively into cars. I had a BM 135, and I tried to work it a little bit in that, but then I got married and then realized how expensive it was. So, you know, I made the mature decision, and now my wife, she's gone. So now I'm joking. So I got rid of the car. I think one day in the future, that's always been a passion of mine, is to build up a bit of a car collection. Financially, hoping for the best there. I think it's also a great way just to spend some time and just to clear your mind a little bit.
100% correct, yeah. And then back to your cricketing career, would you ever be one of the guys that's willing to go elsewhere to sort of make a career for yourself? Would you go abroad to, let's call it America, and chase the Major League dream, which they're launching for next year? Or would you be solely set on staying here and just trying to reignite a flame somewhere else, like we spoke about earlier?
Yeah, sure. It's a good question. I think, well, personally for myself, I've always wanted to play for South Africa since I was a little kid. And that's not a dream that I've let go of yet. Mm-hmm. But also, like I said earlier, I'm looking at different avenues, and the way cricket is going is those leagues around the world.
Yes.
And I think through my career, we've marketed myself as more of a white ball bowler. Yeah. And it's something that I've worked quite hard on, is my white ball skills, and sort of developing that. Yeah. So I think it's a great opportunity. You know, you get a tour or travel the world, doing the thing that you love. So yeah, I think obviously America, I think that's a great opportunity. Yeah. Obviously, I know the leagues in the UK are great. So yeah, I think those are always options on the table. I think from a little kid, you always want to play for your country, and I think it's still a big passion of mine.
Yeah. So one of your old friends, Devin Conway, has done exceptionally well in recent times.
Obviously, so chuffed.
Yeah, I think he'll play one of the next series for New Zealand whenever they get back on the park as well.
Yeah, because he got contracted now, if I'm not mistaken.
100% correct. He did. Yeah. So those are the decisions some guys are making. You know, to go abroad and sort of chase a dream that wasn't really given to them locally.
Sure.
And they're going to show how good they actually are abroad. So you're right, you know, there's many opportunities around the world, and you don't necessarily need to commit to a country as per se, but the opportunities are plenty. T20 cricket and another one, Cameron Dalton.
Definitely.
Is exactly what guys are going about and doing. So yeah, definitely. Diversify, open your eyes, or open our eyes.
Yeah.
Find out what's out there, you know. But I think that's pretty good. You know, we've touched on a little bit of everything, and we'll definitely have a revisit to this, and also what's happened in the time since we've chatted.
Sure.
And hopefully we can get some good news to hear where you're going to be playing. Maybe you're playing in a different color. Maybe you're playing abroad. Sure. We'll wait and see. But lovely chatting to you, bud. Appreciate it.
Awesome. Thanks a lot, Chris. I really appreciate it.
It's a great, great initiative that I'm trying to do here, and just get some awareness out there for each and every one of you guys. So let's keep doing it. And thanks.